Hello friends, welcome to Insight Learners. Today we shall continue with the basic terminal commands. So today we shall learn the basic ls commands. So open the git terminal command. So now we shall learn the various ls options. So as we know that ls is a command which is used for listing all the directories as well as the files and the folders that are present. So there are various options that are used with the ls command. So ls hyphen l, it is used to list all the files in the long format and which also displays the read write permissions, time, as well as the id, as well as the directory in which the file is present. Then the next option is ls hyphen m. So ls hyphen m, it lists all the files across the page and that are separated by the commas. So here you can observe that earlier we have given the command that is ls hyphen l and which displays all the files in the long format, but in case of ls hyphen m, so it displays all the files in a single page and which are separated by the commas. So the next option is ls hyphen n. So ls hyphen n, it displays the user and the group IDs. So here you can check that it displays the group ID. So these are the group IDs. With the help of ls hyphen n, we can observe the group IDs. The next command is ls hyphen o. So ls hyphen o, it lists all the files in the long format and omits the group ID. So here you can check that the group ID is been omitted. There is only the user who is so there is the user name of the user and the group ID is been omitted. And the next option is ls hyphen capital R. So this will recursively list all the subdirectories that are encountered. So you can observe that it's been looping. So there is the subdirectories are been displayed. So all the subdirectories that are present. So directories, within the directories, there it includes subdirectories. So all the subdirectories that are present is been encountered. So it displays all the directories, all the subdirectories that have been present. So it will recursively keep on displaying all the files. So let's close this. So you can check that the processes are running in session. So all the processes that are present, that is the subdirectories, are recursively, it keeps on recursively displaying it until you close the process. So we have closed the process. So therefore, with the help of ls hyphen capital R, we can recursively list all the subdirectories. So the next option is ls hyphen p. So ls hyphen p, it writes a slash after each file name if that file is a directory. So you can see that earlier we created a temp1 directory, temp0 directory. So wherever there is a directory, it displays the directory with the slash. So with the help of ls hyphen p, we can differentiate between the directories as well as the file. So if there is a slash, then you can see that it is a directory, whereas the others are the files. Whereas the others which does not have slash, you can say that they are the files. So these are the various ls options. So with the help of a q, you can quit it. So next thing is we shall learn two important commands, that is a copy command as well as the move command. So before we need to copy the file, we need to create a file. So first we shall create a directory, then we shall create a file within the directory, and then we can copy those file within the, we can copy that file with the other copy. So with the help of mkdir, we shall create a file. So mkdir followed by the name of the file, you can give it as temp. So mkdir temp. So you have created a temp. So you can see that the temp directory has been created. So now currently we are in the home directory. Now we need to switch from home directory to the temp directory. So cd is a command which is used for changing the directory. So cd temp. So now you can check that currently we are in the temp directory. So now we need to create a file within the temp directory. We need to use a touch command. So touch followed by the name of the file, you can give any name. So touch a, you can give the name of the file as a.txt or test anything. So we shall create a name of the file to be test. Touch test. So ls. So you can see that the test file has been created. You can give any extension to the file if you wish. You can give .txt in order to represent it as a text file, or you can give the extension as a .pdf, or you can just name the file with the help of the, you can give any name to the file. You can also create a file without the extension. So with the help of a touch command, we have created an empty file, that is a test file. So upon successfully creating a file, we shall use the copy command as well as the move command. So copy command, that is the copy command, it is used to copy the file. So cp is a command that is used for copying the content of the file with the into the other file. So cp, you can copy the test. So cp test, you can copy it to test1. So ls. So you can see that the contents in the test is also been copied into the test1 file. So we have successfully copied the contents of test file into the test1 file. So it displays both test as well as the test1 file. So suppose if you want to move the file, we want to move the entire file into the other file, so we need to use the mv command. So mv is a command in which it successfully copies all the, it copies the entire file into the other file. So mv test1. So suppose if you want to copy the test1 file into another file, that is test2. So mv test1 test2 ls. So here you can check that earlier we were having a test as well as a test1 file. So upon mv command, we can see that the test1 file is completely copied into test2 file. So test1 file is been deleted. There exists only test2 file, that is we have moved the test1 file completely into the test2 file. So upon ls command, we can observe that there exists only two file, that is test as well as test2 file. So with the help of so ls hyphen p, it recursively displays all the files. So it displays the test as well as test2 file. So the next thing is that ln hyphen s test temp. So ln hyphen s, it is used to create a link. Suppose if you want to create a link, then you need to use a ln hyphen s followed by the file as well as the directory. So then you can see that the temp, so link has been created. So next thing is that another command is to locate the commands. You can also locate the commands using the ls. You need to use a where ls. So where ls is a command, so which is used to locate. So you can, with the help of a where command, you can see that it displays the actual location where we are. So that is the program file git bin as well as the ls.exe. The next thing is ls slash bin. So this command, it is it mainly used for looking up bin folder in the root directory. So you can see that so with the help of ls slash bin, so here you are looking the bin folder in the root directory. So this is the root directory and you are looking for the bin folder. You are looking for the bin folder into the root directory. So these are commands. So in this video we have learned the various ls options, that is ls hyphen l, ls hyphen m. So ls hyphen l, it lists in a long format. Ls hyphen m, it lists the files across the page and that are separated by commas. Ls hyphen l, it displays the name, user as well as the group IDs. Then ls hyphen o, it lists in a long format but omits the group ID. Similarly, ls hyphen capital R, it recursively displays all the subdirectories. Then ls hyphen p will write the slash, it displays the file as well as the directory. So it provides a slash after the directory, so you can easily differentiate between the directory as well as the file name. So if there is a name with a slash, you can see that it's a directory. Then after that we learned the two important commands, that is the cp command as well as the mv, that is the copy command, and as well as the move command. So before using the copy command, you need to create a directory with the help of mkdir. Then after that, you need to create a file, empty file, with the touch command. Then once that is done, you can use the copy command, that is a cp, with the name of the file followed by the name in which you need to copy the contents into the file. So upon that, if you want to move the file completely into the another file, you can use the mv command, that is the move command, which completely moves the file into the another file. And then you can also create a symbolic link with the help of ln hyphen s. So ln hyphen s, s represents a symbolic link. You can create a symbolic link with the help of ln hyphen s, name of the file followed by the directory. So it directly creates a symbolic link. And you can also locate the commands. You can also locate where is what's the location, present location, with the help of a where command. So where ls, it actually it is used to locate the location. Then after that, you can also list the bin folder. So if you are looking, so you can also look the bin folder into the root directory with the help of ls slash bin. So that's all. So this is all the basic terminal commands. So we shall learn more terminal commands in the next video. And thank you friends for watching, and do subscribe our channel for more updates.